Let's create an All About You identity wall. On day one, go ahead and create your wall using tempera paint and a sponge. Here I'm making a brick wall, but you could make some other texture for your wall. If you are going to make a brick wall, you can use 1/3 of a kitchen sponge like I'm using here, and I'm just staggering every other line starting halfway so that it looks like a real brick wall. If you finish making your wall on the first day, clean up your mess, and then you can practice what you want to put in the center of your wall. Is it going to be your name, a saying that you like, or a self-portrait? Whatever it is, on the second day, you are going to make your real main subject, whatever's going to be in the middle of your wall, that is all about you. And you are going to use a white piece of paper and Sharpies for this. Here I'm using lettering to do names, but you could do something else. I want to make it look like it was painted on the wall, so I'm going to paint kind of a blobby shape around my name so that it looks like it was painted onto my wall. If you finish painting your main subject, then while it dries, go ahead and get another piece of paper and start thinking about some imagery that is all about you. Things that you like. Here I picked a color scheme, so I'm only using one color, red, which makes a monochromatic color scheme, but you could use some other color scheme. Here what I'm doing is going back over my Sharpie because it got covered up a little bit with the paint, so you might want to think about finishing touches like that. For the next step, I drew inspiration from the artist Jen Stark. She is a multimedia American artist who lives and works in Los Angeles, California. She's best known for creating optical art using psychedelic colors and patterns and drips that mimic the intricate motifs found in nature. Here we can see some paper layered and it looks like dripping paint. So what I decided to do was draw some layers around my name here. And I drew them with pencil first and now I'm tracing them with Sharpie and I'm trying to make them look kind of like Jen Stark's cool layered works of art. But you can use any sort of style or designs that you want to add to your main subject. I just thought her style is really cool, so I wanted to sort of be inspired by that. Next, I'm cutting out my main subject, which is my name. Another artist I was inspired by is Jay Goldcrown. Here we can see some of his street art. He is known for his bleeding heart spray painted murals. So on the third day, we're going to use chalk to add texture. Here I'm rubbing some chalk into the texture of the dried brick wall and it makes really cool textures all over. You can also use the chalk to sort of mimic spray paint, like Jay Goldcrown created his bleeding hearts using spray paint, but we are going to use chalk to sort of give the illusion of spray paint. So that's what I'm doing here. You could also use paint sticks or actual paint if you wanted to, but I want to go ahead and glue down the imagery that I created all about me. So I'm going to cut those out and sort of arrange them and figure out where I can put them on my brick wall. Here you can see that I'm using dot dot not a lot to go ahead and glue down all of the pictures that I drew about myself, and I couldn't fit everything, so I'm just going back with some markers and writing a few more things about me, and then the fun part, I'm going to splatter paint to really give it some texture and look a little bit more like spray paint. Here are some close-ups of some of the identity walls that you could create.